Welcome back to Solutions for Financial Independence. Joining me now is John Halterman from Beacon Wealth Management. John, how are you today?
Hey, I'm doing awesome, Kyle. How about yourself?
Doing fantastic as
well. All right, great to hear.
Yes, today we have a question from Sarah from Grafton. She says, I have a will and have considered getting a living trust. Could you please explain the difference?
Well, Sarah, you know, the first thing is a living trust is the most basic foundation document of estate planning. What it's going to help do is it's going to help state your intentions, which is fantastic because now they're in writing. But what a will doesn't do is a will doesn't help you with probate. And that's where the difference is with a living trust. A living trust is a true living document that you use while you're living and not just after your death like you do a will. It is a document that is going to help you when the time comes that you pass away. Your family can avoid probate and be able to step in and legally do things for you. So primarily, that's the primary difference between the two is one is just used for after death, one is used after death and while you're living to own assets. Because the other advantage of the living trust is its privacy. The trust owns the assets versus you personally owning the assets.
Absolutely, and that's great to know the differences, but what are some of the advantages?
Well, I think the advantage is if you're a person, and you want privacy, meaning that you don't want your assets to go up on probate, and you do not want to have to go through the probate process, and you want to settle your estate, well then the living trust is going to allow you to do those two things. And that's a huge, huge advantage because for a lot of people, they don't realize that when you have a will, that means that what happens is your assets go through probate, they become public record. Anybody can go and make a claim against them. And so here, it's private, it avoids probate and settles quickly. Now also, if you have an estate that's a significant amount, let's say over $10 million, there's an AB or family trust that's a lot of times included in it, and that allows you to double your estate tax exclusion. So a living trust, basic foundation, the will is the basic foundation, whereas the living trust is the next step in helping you do a better job of planning your estate.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for sharing the differences and the advantages. And if you miss any of that, you can find the full report on WDTV.com. And don't go anywhere. Much more news after the break.